Morning.
Good morning. Good morning. How is everyone today? Good. Yay. Perfect. All right. So, welcome to the Lady Bird Johnson Wildflower Center in my office. My name is Julie Graham, and I am the school programs coordinator here. So if you've ever been out here on a school field trip or come out for a nature night or any type of youth visit, scout visit, you've probably interacted with me in some way or another. Today, we are going to talk about insects. And how do we know that we've got insects and where they've come from, where they are, where they're going, what are they doing? So what I'd like to do is just real quickly, what I would like for you all to do is I'm going to have a PowerPoint presentation, and during the presentation, I might every now and then ask a question. And if you know the answer, if you can just raise your hand up so you can be seen, Roxanne, if you would be able to unmute them so they could answer, that would be really helpful. So we're going to try that. If that doesn't work, at least I've seen that people do know the answers by raising their hands. And then we'll go over and just, I'll show the answers that I've put on my screen, and we'll compare to see if your answers and my answers match up. So we will get started. I hope everyone has joined in. And then also, so you'll know, once we're finished with the PowerPoint presentation, we're actually going to go out into the gardens and look for insects. So there might be a couple of minutes of where you're not seeing me and we're doing a little bit of transitioning, but hang tight and we will be back together. So right now I'm getting ready to share my screen so we can get started with our presentation. All right. Here we go. So who's been here? The first thing I would like for you all to notice is just look at all of these different insects, and not a one of them looks anything like the other. They're all very different, but yet they are all insects. All right. Now, insects, they truly come in all shapes and sizes. You've got here, I'll talk about all of them just real quickly, some little tiny a midge fly, mosquito or house fly, caterpillar, a beetle, and a moth. Now we're going to go back to this one over here. If you look at this in this circle, this little guy right here called a midge, there are different types of midges, and then there's one type of midge fly that's very, very important. I want y'all to raise your hand if you like chocolate. Raise your hand. Put your, if you can turn on your videos so I can see. If you like chocolate, I'm going to put both my hands up because I love chocolate. It is like my very, one of my very favorite foods. All right. There is a type of midge fly called the chocolate midge. And if we did not have that chocolate midge, we would not have chocolate, because it's the chocolate midge fly that actually pollinates the flower of the cacao tree. And that is the plant that gives us what we need to get chocolate. So this little teeny tiny thing, and that little teeny tiny fly is actually, it's probably a little bit bigger than the tip of a pencil. It's about the size of a pinhead, is the size of this little bug, this little insect right here. So it's a tiny little thing, but it is a very most important insect. So we have to remember, before we smush and smash any insects, we have to think about, this could be important. we might really need this insect because some of our insects are pollinators. So we have caterpillars too, and they're kind of long and skinny, and we don't want to smush them because they're going to turn into either butterflies or moths. Now this guy down here, now I want to make sure, can you all see my screen? Okay, thought I'd better check that. This is an invasive species. I included him because he's got a really cool name. This is a longhorn beetle. And since the Lady Bird Johnson Wildflower Center is part of the University of Texas and our mascot is a longhorn, I really felt like I wanted to just put him in there. So this is a longhorn beetle and it has come from Asia and it causes problems. So we don't really want to see any insects like this. So some insects are a real problem. They're an invasive species. This moth over here, this is called the black witch moth, and it is the largest moth that is north of Mexico. It's very common across Texas, and it can have a wingspan of up to 7 inches. So that is from here all the way over to where my finger is, 7 inches. So later on, when this is finished, get a ruler and just look and see how big 7 inches is. And this moth, that's how big it can get. So not only do insects come in all different shapes and sizes, they also have different stages. And what you're seeing here is a complete metamorphosis stage of a butterfly. We've got complete metamorphosis and incomplete. Butterflies and moths have complete metamorphosis. You've got an adult stage, so that's your butterfly, and your butterflies will then lay an egg. From that egg hatches, first you're gonna have a wee little teeny tiny caterpillar, if you can see it in the upper right-hand corner where I'm pointing to. Then, caterpillars, what they do, they only do a few things. They eat, they sleep, and they poop. And they eat, and they sleep, and they poop. And they do that over and over and over. And then they start to get so big, they're going to shed their skin. And then they're going to do the same process over and over again until they've reached their full size. And then they've had enough eating and sleeping and pooping, and they're like, oh, I am tired. It is time for me to take a rest. So now a butterfly will do its thing. It's gonna attach itself to normally a plant where it's gonna be concealed. But sometimes they actually will attach themselves to a fence post. Or I know of a person who had left their hat in an old van. The butterfly attached its chrysalis to this person's hat. And the type of chrysalis it was from a monarch butterfly. And they're really fancy looking, and it almost looked like she had a jewel on her hat. So this is the chrysalis stage. And inside here, this caterpillar is totally doing a transformation, and it will eventually become a butterfly again. Now, one thing important to know, that for butterflies, they're going to form a chrysalis. And if this were a moth though, a moth forms a cocoon. And what you're seeing right up here, this is the cocoon. It's already come out, and you can hardly tell what it is, but a moth has a cocoon, and this is a cocoon of a cercopia moth. And when you, it's kind of hard to see, but usually, cocoons look softer and a little squishier. So that's a big difference between butterflies and moths. Butterflies have chrysalis, moths have cocoons. And when do you think a moth is out and about? Would you say thumbs up if you think it's daytime for a moth? No, thumbs up if you think it's nut time for a moth.
Thumbs up.
Thumbs up if you think a moth is nighttime. I'm seeing some thumbs up. Yes. Thumbs up for nighttime for moths. That's normally when you're going to find a moth, is in the evening time. So this evening, if you go outside and you happen to have a nightlight on, you are probably going to see a bunch of moths hanging out around the lights outside. They really like that for some reason. So our insects have different sizes and shapes. They have different stages. But how do you even know if an insect has been on a plant? I guess one way to figure it out would be to just go look at the plant and see if you see an insect. But there are some other signs that you can look for to find out if an insect has been on a plant. And we're going to look at some pictures now. All right, here we go. Oh, let's look at these leaves close up. My goodness. It sure looks like something has eaten them, doesn't it? Do they look chewed on? Give me a thumbs up if you think these leaves have been chewed on. I think they've been chewed on. Do you think a person did this? Shake your head yes or no. If you think a person chewed on these leaves. No, I don't think a person chewed on these leaves. Let's take a look and see what might have chewed on. Oh, there it was. Caterpillars chew on leaves. They love to chew on leaves. That's one of their favorite things to chew on. That's pretty much all they chew on is leaves. And then also grasshoppers chew on leaves. Now, I don't know if everybody has read the book, James and the Giant Peach. Have y'all been reading that book at all recently? Some people have. Thumbs up if you've read James and the Giant Peach. I just read it. I hadn't read it in a really long time and I had forgotten about it. But in that book, they have a grasshopper that became very special because he ate something magical. And he was a very nice grasshopper. He did not eat leaves. But grasshoppers in real life, they can really destroy a whole lot of plants when they go eating the leaves. So in real life, grasshoppers are a pest. They're not like the great, wonderful grasshopper from James and the Giant Peach. Okay, let's see what's next. What in the world do you think that could be? Have you ever seen anything that looks like that? Give me a thumbs up if you have ever seen anything in your life anywhere. I want everybody to do this. Look what Miss Graham is doing. Do it with your mouth. What are you producing? Is that spit? All right. Let me show you. That's from a spittle bug. So this is called a foam home. Inside of this is a little bug like this, a spittle bug. And what he does is he secretes, he puts out all these little spit bubbles and completely covers himself up. And then he has a little mouth part that pierces the stem of the plant, and he starts sucking out the juices of that plant. But no one can see him. All people see is the foam home. So a bird flying by is not going to see the bug. It's just going to see this white thing that looks like a bunch of spit. So a spittle bug has a very good way to hide itself from predators. All right, let's see what's next. Oh, wow. Look at this. Look at these. They look like roadways to me. These aren't the veins of belief like these are right here. This is something different. They remind me of, look, and over here, they look like roadways, but these are not roadways on the leaf. This is damage from an insect called a leaf miner. So here's what the insect actually looks like, where I'm pointing with my little arrow. And what happens is that a leaf, even though it's really skinny, it has layers. And this little insect right here gets in between the layers and starts eating away. So every place you see something that looks like a little road, it's where that little leaf miner has been, and he's created a pathway. So if you ever see a leaf that looks like this, or like this, or anything similar to that, it's because a leaf miner has been on it. All right, we're getting close to the end of the actual PowerPoint, and we're almost getting ready to go outside, which is the most fun part anyway. Just a couple more. Now this just looks like a rolled up leaf. Have y'all ever seen leaves rolled up? Just rolled up like that? Thumbs up if you have. Thumbs down? No? Haven't seen it? Okay. So if you look close over here on the side, it looks like there might be a little bit of webbing. So I am thinking that there might be something inside of this rolled up leaf. Let's look and see. Yep. This caterpillar. This is called the bur oak leaf roller. And what it does is it gets on a leaf, it rolls itself up, and then it puts some webbing out there to keep the leaf curled up. And then what it does is it starts eating away at the leaf. Now other insects, what they'll do is that they will lay their eggs on a leaf and then curl and roll the leaf over. So their eggs will be protected. And then the insect goes away, but then there's those little eggs in there and they're gonna hatch because they don't have anyone to bother them. They're nice and protected. And then once they hatch, they're gonna start munching away on the leaf. So they're nice and protected, and that's called a leaf roller. All right, so that's another thing you can look for when you're outside. Oh, wow. Have y'all ever seen anything like this before? Yes? All right. They look like eggs, but you know what? They're really not an egg. They're really not. Now, you might find an egg inside of one of these, but this is not an egg. This is what's called a, are you ready for it? A gall. G-A-L-L. A gall. And they're made when the tree or the leaf gets stung are hurt by an insect, and there's special insects that will do this. And they've got a special chemical that causes this reaction. So oftentimes, like this wasp, the gall wasp, it's gonna sting the leaf. But what it's doing actually, it's putting an egg on the leaf, kind of like inserting the egg into the leaf. And the leaf is not happy. It's like, oh no, 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 you are not going to hurt me. So it puts a cover over where it got hurt. Kind of like, have you all ever skinned your knee or an elbow and the skin is raw? Well, after a few days, a scab forms to cover up your wound, to cover up where you got hurt. That's kind of what a gall is like. It's covering up where the leaf was stung. And in the process of making that covering, it's also covered up the egg. So now here we have an egg that's all protected and covered up by this gall, by this material from the plant, and it can grow. And when it's ready to hatch, it hatches, and then it has food right there for it. And it chews its way out of the gall, and it goes on and carries on the life cycle. Now, let's see if we've got anything else. Ah, so we're getting ready to go outside in just a minute. And what I want to remind you of and let you know is that in the chat box, we're going to put a link to a little activity sheet that you can do at your own home. And what I've got is I've got some of the insects and some of the different results of the insects. So you can go in your own yard and tally up to see how many different insects you can find in your yard. So what Miss Graham is going to do now is I am going to end my PowerPoint. I'm going to stop sharing my screen. I'm going to turn off my video, but you keep yours on. And I'm going to mute myself, and then I'm going to head outside so we can actually go on a walk and look for real live insects. All right. I'm stopping my screen. Here I am. Hey, everyone. All right. Now I'm going to mute myself. And
everyone in the garden here, we have this little grasshopper who's just hanging out, checking you out.
All right,
Julie, there's a grasshopper right here just checking everyone out. You see him?
Yes, I do. Can everybody see the grasshopper where my finger's pointing? And that one probably can be seen easier because it's a different color. It's kind of a grayish brown color.
He's letting me get really close.
All right.
And then also, cool. Julie, there is a half-eaten, let me figure out, where did I see it?
A half-eaten leaf?
Flower down here.
Oh, flower.
Oh, there's a fly.
It's definitely a hunt when you're going out looking for insects and evidence of insects.
There's a Turk's cap flower that's half eaten over here.
Yep. And you can even see down here, look at the leaves, the holes, the big chunks taken out of the leaves. And in this one over here, I can actually put my finger through the hole. It chewed a hole right through the leaf. All right. So we're going to start walking. Oh, and I want to let you all know that we're going to walk really slow because we have been told that if we walk too fast when we're doing this, that we're going to make people sick to their stomachs. So we're going to go really slow so no one feels sick during our walk. And we're going to look right over here this way. And if you can get to, do you see the lantana with the butterfly on it up there? Let me see if I can get carefully. It flew. There it goes. It flew away. That was the Gulf Fritillary. All right. We're going to keep looking as we go. Let's see. I don't see anything right down here, so we're going to walk on. Oh, now this is interesting. There's I don't know what that is, but it looks like it's just floating in midair. I wonder if maybe there's a little spider web on that, or if that's an actual insect. Oh. That's hard to tell. And it just disappeared. Interesting.
It's a spider web.
Oh, a spider web. Now, we all think oftentimes spiders are insects, but they're really not. They're arachnids. All right, here we go. Those butterflies like to keep being far out of our way. Let's see. What else? Ah, right down here. Can you see the bumblebee? These insects are tricksy, fast little critters. Just when you get ready to take a really good look at them, they sometimes fly away on you. But we're going to keep looking. Let's keep going. Let's see. I think if we come over to our color garden area, we might be able to find something. Well, oh, there's a wasp. It's a red wasp. I'm not going to get any closer to him. But it's interesting how they like to go down far into the bottom of the plants. Oh, there was something. That's a grasshopper, a great big grasshopper that was jumping. I don't know if you were able to see it. All right. Let's go this way. All right, here we go. Let's see what else we can find. Oh. We're going to be making our way to our pollinator garden, and hopefully we'll see some more butterflies. Let's look. Oh, I forgot my mask. Uh-oh.
You're okay. If you want to go run in real quick, okay.
All right, everybody, I'm going to go run inside and get my mask real quick. I will be right back.
Right now. All right, everyone, I'm going to keep walking as we make our way to the pollinator garden. Oh, here's some spittle bugs. Remember how Julie talked about the spittle bugs? Here's some right here. Sorry, try to get them in focus here. You see them? Here's some right here. And if I were to touch it, it would be all slimy.
You found spittle
bugs? Yep, we found some spittle bugs.
Oh,
right,
perfect.
Here.
Let's see.
Right there, right?
Oh, yes, perfect. Right there. And there. Oh, look at that. And here. And here. And here. Lots of spittle bugs. Oh, great. Is it the dragonfly? Right there. Can you see him? He's on that stick that's curved over to the side. Taking a break. And there's a little tiny one right on that round leaf. Kind of the wings are almost clear. A little blue tip on his tail.
All right, let's keep walking. Oh, everybody. You have to look high and low when you're looking for insects. Do you all ever find loopholes at your house? Sometimes if you move leaves, you might find loopholes. Not right now. I'm not seeing any. But as I said, ants, if you see some big tiny ants, oh, there you go. Don't hurry. All right. Keep walking. What else is out here? Let's see. Oh, they're so quick. Okay, so we've gotten into a shady area. Sometimes insects prefer the shade, but there's other times that the insects really prefer sunshine. I found that the butterflies oftentimes will have a better chance of finding them on a sunny day and in the sunshine instead of on a cloudy day. We're heading into a demonstration garden with a whole lot more plants. Let's see what kind of insects we've got out here. Oh, an insect, a little teeny tiny lizard. Now see that? Oh, there it goes. All right. This was out of the name. We're about halfway to our time, Barbie. We're looking. I see a dragonfly behind the side. I don't know if I can see that. Oh, and there's a little yellow butterfly. Let's see. All right, we're going to come this way. And we're going to pass by a little pond, and we definitely want to look at that pond. We might see more butterflies there, and there's butterflies right here. Can you see the butterflies? All right. There goes a big lizard. Right here, halfway. There he goes. He's going to the shade. All right. Now, yesterday, when I was out looking for different types of insects, I actually saw in this pond over here, I know it wasn't an insect, but I actually saw a little insect in the water. I was going to see if it was there. No, I don't see it in the water today. But there's some little mosquito fish. What do you think mosquito fish eat? They eat
Alona.
Tanya, Julie, can you hear me?
All right. Yes, we can hear you.
Oh, I'm getting some chat remarks that we're not able to clearly understand any of Julie's commentary. I don't know whether it's between the mask and the microphone or if she's not directing her comments towards the speaker on the phone or on the iPad. I'm not sure which device you're using, but no one is able to really clearly understand the comments.
Okay, can you hear me right now?
No, people are saying, shaking their heads. There's static. I don't know how to correct it. Do you want to try again? I can hear your voice, but it's not very loud.
I apologize. We have some new equipment in it with this setup. We have some new equipment. It's the first time it's been set up, so it might be the stuff we have or the masks we have. Yeah. If you want to go back.
Yeah.
Oh, well, there's a lot of suction. I have it.
Well, we'll walk back this way.
Oh, no, that's fine.
And then here we go.
We're breaking up.
Okay, we'll head back. All right, we're
going to
head back.
My phone is on the app, so that might be as well.
Okay. All right. What's the listeners?
What do you think those listeners are after? Do you think they'd be looking for insects? I have a feeling that's what they're looking for are insects.
You just want to go back to your office and wrap up. Just like run back. I'll just
okay. So, listen, everybody.
But you just run back.
Okay.
Oh my God.
Everyone, if you can hear me at all, Joyce is going to run back to her office and wrap up from her office where you can hear clear her. I don't know if it's the audio overheating or if it's the new audio we have and some connection problems. So we will finish up here. I apologize for the audio issues.
Oh, my God.
All right, everybody. I am back in my office. Can you all hear me? Thumbs up. Okay, perfect. I am sorry that the video decided to not behave. I hope you got to see some things. This is the one tricky part of learning this new technology for all of us. But I hope you got to see, did you get to see the butterflies? Some of the butterflies? Yes? And what about the lizards? Did you get to see some of those little lizards? Okay, good. All right, I am so glad you got to see some of that. It is tricky. I am so looking forward to the day when everybody is going to be able to come back out to the Wildflower Center and you all are going to be able to see this for yourselves. It is so neat to see. And definitely, right now we are having, people are able to come out with reservations. You should do that. It is summer, it is hot, but as you can see, we still have so many things in bloom, and people always seem to think that summer is not a good time to see things, but we have got several plants right now that the pollinators, the butterflies, and the bees absolutely love. So there are areas that you can actually walk down a pathway, and it's almost as if you're being just engulfed by butterflies because there are so many as you're walking by. It's fun. It's one of the most fun things I like to do when I walk through the gardens, is to walk through the areas with all the butterflies. They just flitter all over the place. All right, so like I was saying before we went on the walk, in the chat box there should be a link to where you can get that activity sheet, and you should go out. Look for insects. Tally how many you find. And what you could do is you could create, just with a piece of string, or if you've got a hula hoop, use a hula hoop. Put that down and look and see what you find just in that area. And then you could do that, say, do that every day for a week. See if the results are the same. And then wait a week, then try it the next week. So you can be a scientist yourself and really observe what's going on in your backyard or your front yard or your side yard. Just really take an opportunity to go out in nature and look at it closely. But look, don't touch them, because you never know. They might not like to be touched, and then they might decide to sting you, and then that would not be pleasant. Has anyone ever been stung by a wasp? Raise your hand if you've been stung. I have. And I will tell you, I have learned. Do y'all know who Marge Simpson is? The comic, the cartoon? Okay. I have learned how Marge Simpson got her appearance. Somebody must have gotten stung on the lips, because that happened to me, and I looked like Marge Simpson. My lips just got totally swollen, and I looked at myself and I thought, oh my goodness, I look like Marge Simpson. So you don't want to do that. Leave the insects alone. And if you happen to see like a nest up there, let your grown-up know, like, yeah, I see a big nest up there. We need to stay away from that area. But go out, observe, maybe make a little butterfly feeder. So look for those things, look that information up, and I hope you all have a wonderful rest of your day today. Are y'all going to go outside later on? Thumbs up if you're going to go out later on. Good. Or maybe in the cooler part if it gets cooler today. All right. I hope you have a wonderful afternoon. Stay safe out there. You're welcome. Wear your masks when you're out and about, and come and visit us as soon as you're able to. I'm going to go now. You all have a nice day. Bye-bye.